Welcome friends. Today we are going to discuss brief about the MOOCs, massive open online courses, SWAM MOOCs and their implementation for credit transfer, and we will be discussing two of our massive open online courses. As you know, MOOCs stands for massive open online courses. So in an online course, we aim for learning anytime, anywhere, anywhere. So three A's are there. As you know, MHRD, Government of India, is having a vibrant platform of MOOCs, SWAM MOOCs, a platform called SWAM that can be reached through swam.gov.in, and it is providing the access, equity, and quality, three cardinal principles of our education policy. So we need to explore, refer SWAM. What we are having in SWAM, you know, there are online courses available from class 9 to 12 to postgraduate to research students. And it can be accessed by anyone, anywhere, anytime. There are four quadrants there. You will get in quadrant 1 video lecture from experts, in quadrant 2 specially prepared reading material, e-contents that can be downloaded and printed. In quadrant 3 self-assessment tests are there, various tests, quizzes are available there, and in quadrant 4 there is online discussion forum is available for clearing your doubts. It's a wonderful platform. Please do avail the facility provided by the Government of India. Now, how we can go for adopting these MOOCs for our syllabi and for our institutions? As you know, in the government guidelines, SWAM guidelines, the credits can be earned through the SWAM MOOCs. What you have to do, number one, step one is you have to make the amendment through your BOS. Just you have to put that particular MOOC, that this MOOC will be taught, this paper will be taught from this particular SWAM MOOC. Okay, just see whether the syllabi is matching or not. Even if it is matching 70 to 80%, okay, you can take it. And the title may vary, doesn't matter. Okay, when you pass it in your BOS and Academic Council, you have selected that particular course and ensure all the facilities. Then you have to select the mentor. What we mean to say, that it doesn't mean that the there will be no physical classes. You can conduct your physical classes along with the MOOCs. The student will get enrolled in the MOOCs. All the students, when you have said that okay, this subject will be taught through the MOOCs, then all these students will get enrolled themselves mandatorily into that MOOC, and there will be a teacher who is your subject teacher in general, will be serving as a mentor, okay, to facilitate the learning. However, the practicals you will have to go through at your own pace, because the practical in general is the different subject. So only the theory subjects will be taken from the MOOCs. But I mean to say, that theory subject is different, practical subject is different. So when you will be planning the practical subject, so mentor role is very important, because whatever is being read in the theory, you will try to give them the inclination to the practical. Okay, so the mentor role will be very important here. And the last step is disseminating that information. You will have to disseminate, widely disseminate this information about the selected courses, and all these students must get enrolled themselves, and this is the responsibility of the institution. Course registration. University, to facilitate registration of students, every student enrolled for the course in the university must register for the MOOC course, that selected MOOC course. Okay, then the evaluation. The host institution shall evaluate the student registered for MOOC courses. If, say, for example, for the industrial pharmacy, the Garhwal University is the host institution, so it is our responsibility. Basically, this is governed by the Government of India, NTA, National Testing Agency, for each and every subject. Okay, then the marks of internal and external are provided in the mark sheet after successful completion of the proctored term and exam. Okay. And the certificate is given to the student who passed the final exam, which is a proctored term and exam by the taken by the National Testing Agency. That particular student will just surrender or submit that particular certificate, and it should be included as a credit by the by your institute, because they SWAM has given the 4 credit course. Okay, this is the certificate, and the student is eligible for getting the 4 credits. So parent institute can give directly to the students that particular credit. Okay, so it's very simple. It's not you just have to select a course and tell the students that this is the course which you are going to get enrolled for getting the credits this time. Okay. Now we will be discussing a little bit about our two MOOCs. First is academic writing. In academic writing MOOC, it has been the most popular massive open online course in the SWAM, and it ranked number one in India in exam registration and listed in top 30 world MOOCs. In the MOOC, apart from academic writing, the industrial pharmacy MOOC. Industrial pharmacy is the first course of pharmacy which have been developed as a massive open online course. This course is unique in various terms. It is pioneer MOOC in pharmacy, first MOOC for B-Pharm, for students, teachers, researchers, and industry personnel. As far as the academic writing MOOC is concerned, it has got more than 20,000 learners in last 2 rounds. Huge and very successful online course which cater the need of researchers, faculty members, students regarding the writing paper, thesis, dissertation, plagiarism, so many issues. We have addressed the things through the pre-survey, pre-activities we conducted, webinars we conducted, we gave them the feedback. We regularly conduct the webinar, free webinar, in which all the students and learners can clear their doubts. And the all webinars, all learning activities, very useful learning activities we have given. We have got the very huge response for our activity in learning by doing in forums. In discussion forum is available, which is very vibrant. We have given, apart from our content, we have also given the extra features, extra useful videos. Okay, Facebook group is there for learners and for promotion of these courses. We have got the wide coverage podcast, the audio podcast channel we are also providing for our learners. We have a very good team, myself, Dr. Ajay Semalti, Dr. Mono Semalti, and Professor Rajat Agrawal as the instructors. We have the experts in as the academic reviewers, Professor M.S. Amrawat, Professor Joseph, Professor D.S. Rawat, and our team AW constitutes Mr. Lokesh Adhikari is project associate from Garhwal University and Pandwas Creations, who have created this course. As far as the pharmacy course is concerned, there is a first course, and we have got the more than 2,500 learners across the entire country. We created a very interesting learner character journey, gave the live demo of the live instruments. So learner family or environment we try to create. Lastly, I would like to say that we are thankful to our mentors, MHRD, UGC, CEC, AMRC, Roorkee, IIM Bangalore, and NITR Chennai. Lastly, I want to conclude with the words, who dares to teach must never cease to learn. So I request you to promote the SWAM courses, adopt the SWAM courses for your teaching and learning, and especially I invite you to get enrolled. I invite you and your students to get enrolled in academic writing and industrial pharmacy for getting the credits. Thank you for being with us. Happy learning.